For today's video, we're going to jump over to the periodic table and talk about a specific element known as zinc, which is abbreviated as Zn. Now, this is atomic number 30 on the periodic table, and it's in the metals category. In dietary forms, you may see it labeled as zinc sulfate or zinc acetate or a couple other forms, but zinc is very important as an enzyme cofactor. But what exactly is a cofactor? So let's talk about that. When we have some products that need to be made into other products in our bodies, we use enzymes. So in this case, we go from A to B and we use the enzyme number one. But our bodies don't always want those enzymes working and constantly using up all of A to make way too much B. So those enzymes need a cofactor in order to be active. So one by itself is non-active, but one with that cofactor becomes an active enzyme that can then do its job converting A to B. And that cofactor in this case can be zinc. And zinc as a cofactor for certain enzymes can be very critical for DNA repair as well as for the production of hemoglobin. Now, for dietary purposes, top sources include red meat, chicken, nuts and legumes, as well as fortified grains that have been enriched with B vitamins and other micronutrients such as zinc. And also, when we think about zinc related to our immune system, there have been some studies that show that it does help the immune system, but it's been unclear if that zinc supplement is actually just helping to cure an underlying micronutrient deficiency. So to learn more about zinc as a micronutrient and metabolism in general, make sure to check out the free webinar in this video description below.